Kazakh security officials are completing the investigation of the murder of the independent Kyrgyz journalist Gennady Pavlyuk, who was killed in Kazakhstan. The spokesman for the Internal Affairs Minister Konishbek Zhumanov said the names of those involved in the infamous case will be revealed soon.
Kazakh Internal Affairs Minister neither denies nor confirms the information about the involvement of Marat Bakiyev in the murder of Gennady Pavlyuk. Bakiyev, the eldest son of the exiled president of Kyrgyzstan Kurmanbek Bakiyev, worked for that country's National Security Service. Meanwhile, internet users already actively discuss the matter.
В ходе расследования нами установлено несколько граждан Кыргызстана.
During the investigation, we have found several suspects linked to this crime. Please understand that, in the interests of the investigation, the Internal Affairs Ministry cannot comment on the suspects and all details of the criminal case.
Kazakh MPs blame central state bodies and high-ranking officials for the tragedy in Kızılagaş, although without voicing specific names or departments in their message to the Prime Minister. Find out more from the next report.
Kazakh MPs claim people are to blame for the Kızılagaş tragedy and not the nature. Parliamentarians say that the authorities knew about the poor state of the dam but failed to do anything about it. Moreover, according to Murat Abinov, corruption, nepotism, ill-conceived privatization that led to irresponsible management of the dam all led to its break and the deaths of almost 50 people.
The population expects high-ranking officials to finally recognize their mistakes in poor work at the department. It seems that everyone intends to sit this one out except for that single village head who publicly admitted his fault. Without a proper answer, citizens were left in suspense waiting for the next disaster.
At the same time, representatives of the Internal Affairs Minister seem to confirm the MP's words, rounding the same suspects yet again. Besides the mentioned village head, there is also the deputy head of the regional emergency department, Yevgeny Yenin. His children are perturbed, saying that their father practically lived in the infamous dam, but was still jailed.
You really want to make a persecutor out of the emergency department?
Speaking to journalists about the level of his liability, the emergency minister Vladimir Boshko explains that as the main rescuer of the country, he is responsible only for the consequences of emergencies, but not for their prevention. At the same time, he stands up for the cabinet members, saying that they have everything under control.
There are practically no dangerous or overfull reservoirs in the country. All of them are controlled and monitored daily at the request of the Prime Minister.
Nevertheless, Boshko admits that there are more than 70 abandoned reservoirs in Kazakhstan. Many are privately owned and talks to return them back to the communal property are currently underway. Meanwhile, the parliament has already demanded the authorities not to limit their actions to inspections of dams and dikes, but also prosecuted irresponsible regional and national officials.
On Wednesday, more than 20 shared construction interest holders picketed the offices of Kazkommertsbank in Astana. People are outraged about the freezing of the construction of their housing complex Hantengri due to the arrest of the landlord. The next report has more.
About 200 families in Astana became the victims of the deal between Kazkommertsbank and developer Samruk Kazyna. On Wednesday, the most active of them gathered for a peaceful rally in front of the bank. The interest holders called to remove the arrest on the landlord and continue the construction of the residential complex.
Kazkommertsbank doesn't want to find a compromise, believing that only the arrest of Hantengri can be effective. Unfortunately, they forgot that interest holders will suffer as a result.
Representatives of the financial company met and talked to the interest holders. The developer owes nearly $3 million to Kazkommertsbank and the court ordered to arrest the lot. Through a special state program, Samruk Kazyna bought out apartments, paying only a half of the amount to the bank. Now financiers calmed down the people, saying that the talks with the National Wealth Fund are currently underway, although it is not clear how long they will last. The goal of the talks is to pursue Samruk Kazyna to make a specific deposit, which will be used to complete the construction. In addition, Samruk Kazyna proposes the bank to find an alternative mortgage. The interest holders fear that the construction of the residential complex Hantengri may take months or even years to complete. Currently, the project is done by about 85%. Meanwhile, housing owners were supposed to receive their apartment keys back in 2008. Kazkommertsbank leadership, in its turn, promises to speed up the negotiations, while interest holders threaten to organize protests and pickets until their demands will be met.
On April 14th, the action Call the MP started in Kazakhstan. Its organizer, Mohambet Abzhanov, the coordinator of the European Commission's project Shanerak is Our Common Home, decided that the best way to talk to lawmakers about questionable issues is to spam their phone lines.
The MPS proposed to increase fines for the lack of residence permit. According to Abzhanov, this measure will lead to more corruption because migrants without registration would rather bribe the police than pay a fine of $150.
These amendments are not progressive. On the contrary, they can outrage the community, generate new social conflicts and possibly lead to new protests.
Likely, parliamentarians already know about the matter and do not answer calls. Nevertheless, the organizers of the spam campaign are still optimistic and believe that if at least 1,000 people will show their displeasure towards the new bill, the freedom of movement will remain intact in Kazakhstan.
As if in response, state officials also organize innovative mass actions, although accompanied with the requisite press releases and reports. Find out more next.
Pavlodar officials and members of the Social Volunteer Center have organized a peculiar action. They are sure that making the name of the country using people, singing the national anthem and launching balloons will raise patriotism among the youth. Today's action should show that the young generation is not boring and ready to participate in something interesting. This is our way of saying that we are ready for patriotism. More than 300 students did not attend their classes because of the event, saying they could not miss the action because of the elevated feeling of duty. Curriculum department had told us we cannot miss this event. Representatives of the regional Komsomol organization call this patriotism fake. While some students sang anthems and launched balloons, others were cleaning the yard, confident that their love for the motherland should be expressed in some other ways.
This is actually not patriotism. Nowadays people do not need shows. There are enough of them on the TV. Patriotism should be displayed through our own work.
The action of the authorities was different from the similar events organized around the globe. As usual, Kazakh officials released special press releases and then reported about the accomplished work to the local city council. Unfortunately, the organizers failed to mention the cost of this patriotic education, only noting that four similar events have been planned already.
These were all the latest updates from Kazakhstan. Stay with us and goodbye.